Don't forget to check out and grab your copy of our two newly released books, Football, A Love Story, and What Did Football Teach Me? These books feature over 100 stories from current and former coaches, players, executives, and entertainers from across the football landscape, describing what got them involved in the game, what they love about it, and what life lessons the game taught them. You can find your copy or order your copy from our website at footballgameplan.com/books. Welcome to footballgameplan.com, where football makes sense. I'm Emory Hunt, the czar of the playbook. Bring you our 2016 NFL mock draft for February. This will be a two-rounder, and I'm going to be joined by our football game plan analyst, Teron Davenport, who will bring you the first round. So without further ado, here's Teron Davenport with the number one overall selection. You know, before we get started with any mock draft here at Football Game Plan, we have to give you the Football Game Plan mock draft rules. And number one, these picks are based off what we would do with the personnel and the rosters and the teams if we were the GM and or the head coach. And the final rankings are not complete. So if you see a guy at the same position above another player, don't think that, okay, we have this guy rated higher than this player. The final rankings are not done, so don't trip out about that. And number three, and most importantly, it's only a mock draft. Read that to yourself three times softly before you start this video. But now, without further ado, like I said earlier in the opener, let's kick things off to Teron Davenport as he gets this mock draft rolling with the first overall selection, the Tennessee Titans.
With the first pick in the draft, the Titans select tackle Laremy Tunsil. This will allow them to upgrade both tackle positions. Tunsil will come in and play left tackle, moving Taylor Lewan over to right, giving them a better opportunity to protect quarterback Marcus Mariota, who ended last season on injured reserve. The Browns get what many feel is the best player in the draft in Joey Bosa. Bosa is a disruptive pass rusher. He's stout against the run, giving Ray Horton an added piece to go with Danny Shelton on the defensive line. Protecting Phillip Rivers is the most important thing for the Chargers. One way that they could do that is by adding Ronnie Stanley. Stanley gives them an athletic left tackle that could come in and be an upgrade over the aging King Dunlap. The Cowboys' offense was at its best when it had a run-first mentality. If I'm Dallas, I'm grabbing Ezekiel Elliott and putting him behind that offensive line. It will allow them to be a run-first offense once again and take the pressure off of Tony Romo, putting it on their strongest unit, which is the offensive line. Vernon Hargreaves is the best cover corner in the draft. The Jaguars can pair him with corner Aaron Colvin and have a young set of aggressive press corners for years to come. The Ravens secondary needs to add a playmaker. Jalen Ramsey gives them an option at both corner and safety, but I see him as a safety in that defense. He's a ball hawk, turnover causing type of safety that will help that defense get back to that mentality of being able to create more turnovers and bringing energy on the football field. Laquon Treadwell is a perfect fit for Chip Kelly and the 49ers offense. He could work the slot position because of his big body. He's also sure-handed, which will allow them to feature him more in that offense because of his extra ability to get yards after the catch. The Miami Dolphins struggled to cover running backs out of the backfield and tight ends. One way that they can improve that weakness is by adding the athletic linebacker, Miles Jack. Jack will match up with those tight ends, with the running backs. In addition to that, his lateral pursuit ability will help the run defense. Mackenzie Alexander is a close second to Hargreaves when it comes to cover corners in this draft. He could shut down opposing wide receivers, a lot like Josh Norman from the Panthers. The Bucks get their top level corner that they really need in that defense in Alexander at pick number 9. The Giants need a playmaker on the defensive line. Jason Pierre-Paul, his future is in doubt. If I'm the Giants, I'm selecting Shaq Lawson here. He led the nation in tackles for loss and also was coming off a dominating performance against Alabama in the national championship. Vic Fangio is still incorporating a 3-4 defense with the Cleveland Browns. One thing that he really needs is a pass rusher. Noah Spence is the guy here. He gives them plenty of juice off the edge, and that will allow the Bears to move Pernell McPhee around, who is one of their most versatile defenders. The Saints face the Panthers twice a year. In doing so, they see the advantage of having an athletic set of linebackers. Jalen Smith is the pick for the Saints. They compare him with Stephon Alexander. That gives them a very athletic duo of their own. Smith can blitz the inside gaps. He could pick up receivers in zone. He could cover. He's an excellent pick for them because of his range, and he'll be an instant upgrade for that defense. Jack Conklin is the pick for the Eagles. Jason Peters isn't getting any younger. In fact, last season he fell off. One of the things that they need to do is upgrade that offensive line. Conklin could come in and play left tackle, allowing Lane Johnson to stay on the right side, and this way they don't have to rely on a guy in Jason Peters that quit on them last season. Ken Norton Jr. gets his enforcer against the run in Reggie Ragland. Ragland is a downhill thumper that will come in to start at middle linebacker. That will allow them to move Curtis Laughlin to the outside. The Rams need help at quarterback. Jared Goff is the first quarterback off the board. He could come in and not have to worry about carrying the franchise. He'll be able to hand the football to Todd Gurley, and they can also incorporate a set of plays to get the ball out of his hands quickly and into the hands of playmakers such as Tavon Austin. The Lions need help on the offensive line. Taylor Decker will come in and start at right tackle for them, while Riley Reiff plays left tackle. Reiff is a free agent after this season. If he moves on, Decker could move over to left tackle. If he doesn't, then they just have a set of bookend tackles to protect the quarterback for years to come. The Falcons can instantly upgrade the outside linebacker position by adding Darren Lee. Lee can cover, he's an athlete, he's a classic run and hit linebacker that they could also use on a variety of blitzes to attack the quarterback. Cody Whitehair is the most versatile offensive lineman in the draft. The Colts will be able to get a guy that could compete at either guard position or right tackle. He's able to handle speed off the edge at tackle, and he has the strength for hand-to-hand combat along the inside. Kevin Dodd is the pick for the Bills. Mario Williams may not be back. They're going to need a player that could play left end. Dodd is a very disruptive player, and that is exactly what Rex Ryan likes. He was second in the nation with 23.5 tackles for loss. He dominated Alabama in the national championship. He will be a really good addition to that Bills defensive line. The Jets are lacking sizzle off the edge. Leonard Floyd is a playmaker that is tailor-made for the 3-4 defense. He will instantly come in and give them a situational pass rusher with double-digit sack potential. Jerron Reed quietly was the best player on Alabama's defensive line last year. The Redskins can add a guy to come in and help them against the run because of how stout he is, and he hustles after the ball. He will take over as the three technique in Washington's defense. Hunter Henry is a tight end that will allow the Texans to work the middle of the football field, take advantage of double teams that are all the attention will be given to DeAndre Hopkins. He's a playmaker. They could come back and get a quarterback later, or they could sign Robert Griffin III. The Vikings add Michael Thomas, a downfield threat that could also get open on slants. He gives Bridgewater a big target that could be an option in all dimensions of the passing game. Marvin Jones and Mohamed Sanu are both free agents. Corey Coleman is a burner for the Bengals that will see plenty of single coverage opportunities because of AJ Green on the opposite side. In addition to that, he gives a different playmaking dimension to that offense. Kendall Fuller fits the tough, feisty mold of corners that the Steelers like to select. He could play press, he could bail, he could mirror receivers. He's not afraid to mix it up against the run, and he's a perfect selection for the Steelers at pick number 25. The Seahawks take Jason Spriggs. They're going to have to move on from Russell Okung. He's a free agent, and he's coming off an injury. Spriggs is an NFL-ready tackle that can handle the speed off the edge. He can block on the move, and he answered any questions about his ability to handle stronger power defensive ends at the Senior Bowl. B.J. Rodgers is likely moving on from the Packers, leaving a starting spot for Andrew Billings. Billings is a high-motor player that consistently beats double teams and walks linemen back to the quarterback. He could even drop back into coverage on zone blitzes, which is a great trait for a creative defensive mind such as Dom Capers. DeForest Buckner gives the Chiefs a 5-tech that dominates at the line of scrimmage. You put he and Dontari Poe on the defensive line, and you will cause offensive coordinators to be very hesitant to run the football. Emmanuel Agba gives the Cardinals a bully off the edge that can challenge Marcus Golden for a starting spot. He can also play defensive end in nickel situations. His physical style of play fits right into the Cardinals' philosophy on defense. Darian Thompson is a great fit for the Denver Broncos because of TJ Ward's ability to play in the box. They're going to need a free safety with range. Thompson has the size to match up with tight ends, and he can cover plenty of ground in single high coverage. The Panthers have Calvin Benjamin and Teddy Ginn manning the outside, but there's a void for a slot receiver. Tyler Boyd is the pick here because of his sure-handedness and his ability to be a possession receiver and make plays in the middle of the field. He will give Cam Newton another weapon and make that offense even more deadly.
Thanks to Ron. I'll take it from here with round two. Some solid picks made in the first round. I was able to build on what he was able to give these squads in round two. Quarterback Cardale Jones, I think, is the best quarterback in this draft class, and he's a guy that can give Cleveland what they're looking for at that position. A ton of Ohio State guys back-to-back-to-back with Eli Apple, Braxton Miller, who can play alongside Dez Bryant. I think it would be an outstanding combination. You also look all the way down at Jacksonville. Sheldon Rankins is probably the better defensive tackle in this draft class. He goes to Jacksonville. That'll be a steal for these guys. You look over at the second column. Deion Jones out of LSU had a tremendous Senior Bowl week, but he's been a tremendous player since he stepped foot on campus at LSU. Finally got the opportunity to showcase that this season. The Los Angeles Rams with two picks in the second round, 43 and 45. I gave them two outstanding players in Kyle Friend, the center out of Temple, and Will Fuller, the wide receiver out of Notre Dame. You look at 47, the Saints, Sua Cravens, giving them a guy like Cravens that can play linebacker or safety, teaming him up with fellow rookie Jalen Smith, gives the Saints two home runs in back-to-back selections. Moving over to the back half of the second round, you see three quarterback selections in Dak Prescott going to Houston, Trayvon Boykin going to Pittsburgh, and Christian Hackenberg going to Arizona. I think all three are ideal fits for what these teams want to do offensively. Holland Miller, the outstanding cornerback from southeastern Louisiana, lands in Washington. Victor Ochi, another small college guy, going to Cincinnati. I think he's a tremendous pass rusher and probably will be behind, in my opinion, a guy like Noah Spence coming off the edge. And some running backs coming off the board as well. Aaron Green out of TCU. Kenneth Dixon going to the Carolina Panthers. Overall, some solid talent here. Guys from smaller schools making their way up the draft board up into the second round. You also look at a guy that I think very highly of in tight end Sean Price would be an ideal H-back type to go along with Rob Gronkowski with the New England Patriots. Wide receiver Leonte Carew lands in an ideal spot, I think, would be a perfect fit for the Atlanta Falcons. And one of my favorite prospects in the draft, Sebastian Tretola, the guard out of Arkansas, would do a great job clearing the way for Adrian Peterson.